Welcome, and thanks for joining. I'd like to share with you the things that we have been doing in the last 2 years in the area of SAP and Mendix. We, that is Cosan Beet Company, and we are part of Royal Cosan, a cooperative of 8,000 growers. We produce feed, food, energy and bio-waste products, and we are somewhat of a different company because we've got a 6 month period in which we do harvesting and beet processing, and we've got a 6 month period in which we do growing of beets and maintenance. And of course, we're open 12 months a year for business. We've been using SAP since 1989, started out with SAP R2, and have been using Mendix since the beginning of 2019. At Cosan Beet Company, we use SAP in almost all of our processes. The complexity of those processes could be best summed up as medium to low, and we've got two big areas of differentiation, one in the area of agriculture and the other one in the area of maintenance. Over the years, we've created a lot of tailor-made programs and components, approximately 600 of them, and that took us a combined effort of 40 man-years over the last 20 years. So, we started out with SAP R2 back in 89. We started out with a 4.0 version and migrated to a 5.0 version later on, which already was a big task. Even later, we migrated to R3, which was an even bigger task, and now SAP wants us, as SAP customers, to migrate to SAP S/4HANA before the end of 2027. And if you're willing to give them some extra money, you can even postpone that to 2030. So that's another 5 to 8 years before we have to migrate. And in those years, a lot of things can happen. So we had to come up with a strategy on what would be the best way to move forward for Cosan Beet Company. A migration like that is a daunting task. It takes a lot of energy, effort and money to migrate to SAP S/4HANA. It gives a lot of internal focus instead of customer focused. And we thought for ourselves, well, what would be the benefits for us for migrating? Like I said earlier, our processes are relatively simple, yeah, not too complex. So for us, we perceive the benefits of the migration as limited. And on top of that, we have to solve the issue with the tailor-made software. And you're probably thinking, well, you shouldn't have developed those programs, but like so many customers of SAP, we did, and now we have to solve that. And we come up with a simple strategy. And that strategy is really very, very simple. Instead of focusing on the end part, the migration, we're now first focusing on the simplification of SAP and an innovation at the same time. Our strategy is really, really simple. Instead of focusing on the migration part, we first focus on the simplification part and innovate at the same time. And where do we innovate? Well, you probably guessed it. We innovate and simplify where it matters most to us, namely the tailor-made solutions. So how did we get to this stage? So we started out in the experimentation phase with the project side. When you look at the way we do projects, then sometimes we have a lot of rework. That's mainly because people are easier in giving response and feedback to real-life prototypes instead of a lot of specifications. So we experimented in some of the projects with an agile way of working to see what the results would be. And some of them really surprised us. In some of the projects we did, our end users said that they would rather use, let's say, an intermediate solution, which they could use tomorrow, instead of the full-blown solution that they could use in a couple of weeks or months. We also experimented with low-code, and we did that in two stages. First, a small two-day discovery. And secondly, after the success of the first one, we did a 5-day proof of concept. During that proof of concept phase, we had a limited time of 5 days and tried to recreate as much as possible of solutions we already developed earlier. So we developed a seed ordering module, which we used in the agri side, and we used to develop a mobile maintenance application. We involved both end users into the process and IT staff. And during those 5 days, we also worked in, with agile practices. Our IT staff was asked two questions. First of all, the hardcore developers were asked how much low-code would help them in increasing speed and development. So, in essence, how much easier that would be. our SAP consultants were asked the question how they thought that low-code could either contribute in creating solutions for our end users, and if they, as SAP consultants, were also able to develop and contribute in developing in low-code. All the answers were positive, otherwise I wouldn't be here. So in January 2019, we started out in working in an agile way. We did that in the first week by training both business and management and IT personnel in agile practices. And in week two, we started out with our first planning session. And from there on, we are in a 10-week increment with two-week sprints and are using the method ever since. In March 2019, we started out with using Mendix. And that was also the start of our SAP to standard transition program, in which we try to reassess the SAP tailor-made solutions and see how we can solve them best by either using Mendix or SaaS solutions. So over the past 2 years, we've been developing quite a lot of solutions, and I'd like to share with you some of the solutions that we are very proud of. First of all, the SAP Agri module, AGRIS, which is Agricultural Information System, which is a solution that we have developed with ABAP programs in SAP. We transferred the full functionality for our German location now to Mendix. So that's the contracting part, that's the planning part, the seed ordering part, beet reception, quality control, and first, second, and final payment settlements. This solution is connected to SAP, twofold. On the one side, a connection to master data, and of course, the financial postings, which go back to SAP. This solution really helps us in our simplification because it removes quite a lot of the 600 tailor-made programs, but at the same time, it provides us with a jump board for future innovation. So on top of the internal Agri solution, we developed a portal for our growers and are now in the process of developing portals for both our logistics partners in agriculture as well as the loading partners that we use. Our second solution is the Crop Advisory. With the Crop Advisory, we combine information from different sources and give our growers tailor-made, plot-specific, so the area where they grow their beets, plot-specific growing advice. In the Crop Advisory, we combine information collected by our field staff, data from open sources, and data that's collected from a network of 600 IoT sensors that are scattered throughout the Netherlands. These sensors measure the temperature and the humidity beneath the foliage of the sugar beets, and combined with the HANA advisory model, they give a personalized and localized advice to growers. It helps them and it helps us to reduce the amount of herbicides that we have to use in order to keep our plants healthy, while at the same time maintaining and even increasing the yields. A second solution that uses IoT sensors is our storage advisory. When we harvest our sugar beets, they're stored in the fields in big stacks for approximately 2 weeks before they are transported to the factory. And like any plant-based material that's out in the open and open to the elements, they decay over time, increasing in loss of yields. So we developed an IoT sensor in a sort of IoT thermometer, which our growers can put in the stacks, and it measures temperature at three levels in the stacks. And based on the development of that temperature, we give our growers an advice and a signal whether or not they should cover the stacks or aerate the stacks in order to keep the temperature constant and thus keeping the yields and the sugar content in the beets. We are also using SAP plant maintenance quite extensively. All the big equipments of our plants are stored in SAP plant maintenance, together with malfunction history, documentation, and all other types of information. And with Mendix, we've created a mobile maintenance application, which we've given a name, TIRA, which gives our maintenance engineers full access to equipment data, malfunction history, spare part information, documentation, and the work orders and rounds that they have to do. For example, they can look up the spare parts of an equipment or of sub parts of the equipment and see how much of that spare part is available in other locations. It also gives them easy access and an easy opportunity to enter malfunctions and observations in the field, enter the data from their rounds, the outcomes, and also give response to work order status. And in the end, they can also log the time that they worked on the work orders. We used to have quite a lot of shell transactions in SAP. So TIRA not only helps our maintenance engineers because it gives them a rich user experience and access everywhere on a very large plants, but it also simplifies entry and thus resulting in better quality of data and helps us enormously with simplification by getting rid of those tailor-made shell programs. And finally, in the area of sugar logistics, we have made a dock planner, which gives our external transporters and also our internal transport the possibility to book time slots at our docks. And that really helps us in reducing the waiting time at the docks, and also helps us in digital communication and data exchange with our transporters. It results in reduced waiting time, like I said. It gives, while at the same time giving us less internal effort and resulting in a better planning. So, time is limited, so I cannot show you all the solutions that we have created, but the Agris and TIRA maintenance app are examples where we simplify, and in almost all the solutions that we have also developed, we also have developed some very innovative things for Cozumel company. So, did Mendix help in any way, you probably ask? Well, of course they did. First, by developing in Mendix, you create in a really short time working prototypes of solutions instead of specifications. And that really helps in the collaboration with our end users because it gives them the opportunity to respond to those prototypes that we developed and give direct feedback which we can use to improve the product. It brings, in essence, the fun back into creation. So Mendix also helps with the simplification, like with the Agri example and the TIRA example, and helps us in our flexibility and overall speed to reach our innovation potential. And as an SAP customer, working with Mendix is working outside of the SAP framework, and I must say that is really liberating. Yeah, the possibilities seem endless. But there's also a flip side to that, because a lot of people now think that you can solve all problems with Mendix. And while you can solve a lot of problems with Mendix, sometimes it's better to solve some of the problems with either SAP or a SaaS solution. So working with Mendix also gives you a new task to manage the perception of your end users. So what's the value that we realize for Cozumel Beet Company? In the area of beet supply, in our value chain, we have either increased or protected yields, which benefits us for approximately 1.8 million per year. And our dock planning solution reduces waiting time by approximately 600 workdays a year. We haven't measured the effect of our TIRA application yet, but I probably think that it will help us in either saving time, because our maintenance engineers can use it in the field, while at the same time improving data quality. In the end, we've delighted our users and surprised our management, and our Mendix development team has doubled in the past 2 years. So, our core developers thought that working with Mendix would be 5 times faster than working with SAP UI5. And our SAP consultants can also provide in the products. So overall, we've calculated that working with Mendix has helped us, and working without Mendix, then we could only have realized maybe 15% of our ambition. So, finally, my advice to you is to discover and see for yourself. Investigate how Mendix can help you in your SAP transition. Yep. Conduct some experiments and see where the sweet spots are for your company, because they're probably different for each and every one of us. And then think back, big, create small, and then either succeed or fail small, and learn. And I promise you, the ride will be fun. So, enjoy the rest of your Mendix world, and maybe see you later.
Thank you.